Welcome to Weld.com. Today we're talking about ways to improve flux core welding with gas, also known as dual shield. Like most MIG processes, this is used heavily in production because the deposition rate is very high. And because speed is of the essence, diagnosing problems quickly is key. So today, besides learning to optimize our setup, we're going to touch on issues that you may run into and how to solve them very quickly. So let's get started. So you come into work one day and someone was using the machine before you were, and you have a task you want to do, and it consists of flux core and the machine. You come over here and lift the top up, and the machine was set up for GMAW. You want to set the machine up, and today we're going to use the Lincoln Ultra Core Clarity C71LE 045 diameter wire with CO2, which manufacturer recommends, with an AWS spec of A5.20. So you evaluate the situation. Wire's got to be changed out. The rollers, check the liner to make sure you have the correct liner, which is, it's a 045 liner is already in it. So what we'll do is we'll start out by changing the rollers. So everything that I'm doing, except for the liner, will definitely improve ways to flux core weld with gas for sure. Because if you use the old rollers, the old straight rollers, it'll just smash it, and then you'll have problems driving it. And of course, your welds look like garbage. So let's get started changing the rollers. Of course, you want to look on the rollers because some rollers come with different sizes on either side. So you make sure you have the right side on the right diameter wire you're going to use. So 045, there's 045. Click it in. Okay, next what we'll do, we'll pull the spool off and put the other spool on it. And you see Lincoln puts this in a nice package. So when you cut it open, you want to cut it open so you can reuse it, because if you're going to reuse, take the spool off and reuse it, you want to package it right because you don't want the wire to go bad. There it is. So you put the tip on it, put the cup, trim the wire a little bit. Now we're ready to weld. What I also like to add too is a cleaning brush and a lube brush. I like to put the lube brush on first. I like to use these cleaners and lube so it makes everything roll a lot better. So when you're welding, you don't get intermittent. Everything runs real smooth, and that's what you want. It's just that easy. So today I'm gonna clean up these T-joints before I get started with the furred polyfan curve. And these things work really well, as you see. That's why I like using them. And the word is, I prefer furred. So of course, before you get started welding, you have to set the machine up. So we're gonna start with this Power MIG 260 by Lincoln that I like using the machine. It runs very well. It's easy to program. And you can tweak the parameters if you don't like the presets that's on it. You got your manual, got your MIG, got your flux core shielded, and then you got your flux core with gas. So we'll get started there. Select that. Of course, we're using 045 wire. And a little trivia. You know there's over a mile of wire on an 045 33-pound spool of wire. Look it up. It only goes to 5/16, so we'll use it anyway. Of course, another thing I didn't explain either, when welding flux core with gas, you use a DCEP that's a positive polarity. So we'll confirm this. So it starts out pretty hot. I'm gonna raise the inches per minute to 375 and start from there. Turn this down a little bit, start at 27. I'm gonna tack these T-joints up, and that's what we're gonna demonstrate. I'm gonna run some nice passes on it, and then I'm gonna run a couple so we can figure out what makes the welding better.
How about?
So you can see the profile of the weld. It's kind of got kind of dips in it here and there, and I'm not really happy with it. So that's why they say backhand or pull technique. So I'm gonna show you the backhand pull technique. So of course, this is the pull technique, and of course I started here. And the profile of the weld looks really good because it filled it up and it's real nice and even. I don't see any deficiencies or any kind of porosity or anything in it. So using the right technique will definitely help improve your flux core welding. So what I'm gonna do to try to throw porosity is I'm gonna go all the voltage I can get, which is 28.5. And I'm gonna turn the wire speed down to 250. And of course, I'll turn the gas way down. So of course, as you can see, this is where we have problems. Lack of gas, too high volts. It's a very good demonstration for a screwed up looking weld. So, and the way to fix it is, of course, turn your perimeters down and turn your gas up. I'm using CO2, so I suggest using between 30 and 35 CFH. So next we'll turn the gas way up and keep the volts really high. Here, I was trying to get it to show the wormholes. And they say too much gas and too much volts, too high volts, too much will give you wormholes. Well, obviously it didn't, because this Lincoln wire just kept welding. And I'm not going to say it's a perfect weld. It's an acceptable weld. But I was trying to make it screw up. And guess what? So I'm gonna go get some old wire that's been sitting on the shelf for a while that's gonna produce wormholes. So this is my candidate, and this is what we're gonna use to get those wormhole results. So just like earlier in the video, if you guys were watching and paying attention about storing this wire and handling it right. See, if you do it right, you can reuse it. Just take some tape. Like so. That way it stays nice and dry. So as you can see, I got exactly what I was wanting to show you. Wormholes, porosity, and that's all caused from bad wire, low gas, and probably too many volts. If I tried to do this again, it would never happen. But with that Lincoln wire, I couldn't get it to work because that Lincoln wire is really good. So as you can see, the pinholes and the wormhole porosity all through the weld. So hopefully y'all learned something from this, because it's really simple. Good gas coverage, good clean wire that's been stored correctly or brand new, perfect voltage, or somewhere around the perimeters really close. Not too high, not too low. Thanks for watching today. If you have any questions or need help, go to our forum and connect with us, welddotcom/forum. If you want to check out exclusive content and member perks, join our channel and support the welddotcom community. See you on the next one.